So today we're going to talk about melatonin and all the benefits that potentially can occur that go beyond just the sleep benefits. Now, I'm not recommending taking melatonin as a supplement unless you are treating a very specific thing. For example, there's some great data that shows that high levels of melatonin can improve dementia or Alzheimer's, and I'll put a link down below for that video if you haven't seen it already. But for the general public, I don't recommend taking melatonin. Why? Because your body can make its own. Now, it is true that as you age, it makes less and less and less, but there are things that you can do right now to improve it. But for this video, let's just talk about the benefits that go beyond the sleep cycles, okay? Number one, melatonin is a very potent antioxidant. In fact, it's twice as strong as vitamin E, and it has the potential to increase other antioxidants like glutathione, especially in your mitochondria. So this just backs up the benefits of getting enough sleep, because if you're not getting enough sleep, you're definitely not getting enough melatonin. Well, I probably could have entitled this video, Benefits of Getting Enough Sleep. Okay, number two, immune system support. Melatonin highly influences your immune system. So the less melatonin, the less resistance you have against pathogens and the more problems you have. Melatonin is a powerful anti-inflammatory. So the less melatonin, the less sleep you have, the more inflammation you're going to have. Also, melatonin can help reduce headaches. It has anti-cancer properties. It has neuroprotective properties. It helps with memory and preventing dementia. There's some great data. I just released a video on it, and I'm going to put a link down below, that reveals that if you actually take higher levels of melatonin, it can decrease LH, luteinizing hormone, that is connected to Alzheimer's. You can check out that video down below. It's very, very interesting. All right, number eight, it can help you decrease GERD. That is a situation where you have acid that's coming up through into the esophagus from the stomach. Number nine, melatonin helps reduce anxiety. I mean, this makes sense because people that don't sleep, they become anxious. They worry. Number 10, decreased depression. Same thing, if you're not sleeping, you're gonna be tired, you're gonna be depressed. Number 11, improving blood sugars. We know that if you don't sleep, your blood sugars are gonna definitely be off. One thing you need to know is that as you age, your melatonin drops down. So what can you do to bring it back up? Well, what stimulates melatonin? Darkness. So make sure that in your bedroom, at least an hour before you're going to sleep, you turn some of the lights off if you're watching TV. Don't have a lot of the lights around you because it's gonna confuse the body. Darkness stimulates melatonin. The sun during the day will inhibit the melatonin production of the pineal gland and help melatonin recharge. So if you're inside all day and you have fluorescent lights and you're sitting behind your computer, a lot of blue light, that can prevent your pineal cells from recharging melatonin. So we want sun during the day, sun exposure, good amount of vitamin D, and then we want dark at night with less blue light. There's a great app that you can get that will filter out blue light. I'll put a link down below as well. You want to avoid eating right before bed, okay, because that can actually mess up your sleep and inhibit melatonin production. Glucose will also inhibit melatonin production. So a high-carb diet is not good. We want a low-carb diet. I think that's called keto. Okay, decrease the amount of TV right before bed. Sometimes people are watching a lot of TV and maybe the wrong types of shows that rev up the adrenaline and then they can't sleep at night. So maybe a small amount of TV before you go to bed, but something that doesn't keep you up at night. There are also foods that you can eat that have melatonin in those foods. Mushrooms have a good supply of melatonin. Eggs do have melatonin. Fish and nuts. So these foods can help increase melatonin as well. And on that note, I'll see you in the next video.
Hey, we're back
with another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely. You have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple. We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.